got a good testimony. Yes, hallelujah.
Yesterday, my son-in-law, they rushed him to Vanderbilt to do emergency surgery. He had gotten an infection at work, and they said he had staph, and they were worried about him losing his right arm. Well, we began to pray, and there were people praying all over for him. They did the surgery last night. Turned out wonderful. It wasn't in the tendons like they thought it was. And he's on his way to recovery. And they're just giving him antibiotics to clear his blood. But he believes in the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And he's a strong believer, so I expect him home probably today or tomorrow.
Amen.
Got a good testimony about what God has done for you in 2016. Go ahead, tell it.
Delivered me from cancer. No more.
Well, I just wanted to say that I thank God for my church family and for our relationship with the Lord, because it's just been
better and better, but I had a lot of allergic reactions, you know, and it wasn't a pleasant thing, you know, and it was kind of a scary thing when it was going on, and I had one here on the 29 again, but I caught this one early, and so I'm expecting that's the end of all of this mess.
It's
been awful, but God, he says he'll never leave us nor forsake us, and he won't. Because if you're saved, he's living in you, and he just wants to live out his life through you.
Yes.
But we serve a good God, and
yes.
I know the battle's the Lord, and the victory's ours in
yes.
every situation.
I'm telling you.
Amen. God's good.
Brother Ronnie, come up here. All elder man, come up here. Let's pray for Brother Ronnie. Don't only pray for him. Let's believe that this assignment is broken. Because any time the devil will come down, it's an assignment. That's God. It's another being here to run the devil way back. Amen. Oh, Father God. Lord, we love Brother Manny. Lord, he loves you. He's a blessing to the kingdom of God. And we know this assignment is from Satan. And we break it. We reverse the curse in the name of Jesus. And we believe with all our heart that it will not happen no more. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name. Lord, we believe your Holy Spirit. Just make the brother Ronnie whole from the top of his head to the soul. We'll give you all the praise, all the praise, all the praise. I see out of our sight. You lying devil, you keep your hands off of God's property. In Jesus' name,
Lord.
In the name of Jesus, keep your hands off of him in Jesus' name. Glory to our city and our side. I believe it in my heart, and I confess it with my mouth. Brother Danny is made whole from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. In Jesus' name. Jesus, yes. In Jesus' name. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Praise him, church. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Hallelujah. We need to pray one for another. Hallelujah. Who else got to get that? No, sister. Sister Dan.
You know, I do. This year has been the most trying year of my life. But I'm here. And I'm
yes.
still praising God and thanking him. And there's been miracles throughout the year. My brother had a stroke in December, a year ago, and, you know, he could have died, but he did. God used me in his life for 5 months. During that time, I didn't know whether I was going to survive or not. I was totally alone, and I've had to do things and make decisions you never know what's right or wrong. But I was faithful. And those of you who know me, prayed for me, supported me, loved me through it all. And I'm so grateful and thankful for my church family, for my friends that are so loyal and understand the situation. And I was weak at times. I thought, oh, Lord, I can't go through this. I can't do this. But, you know, let me give me strength. During that time, I had to take over the finances, get his house ready to sell, return 3 cars, and give the world to him, put him in a nursing home, assisted living, whether he liked it or not. He wasn't able to fend for himself. I'd done everything I could in 5 months' time to where I was so worn out I couldn't think. But, you know, kind of faithful, like I said, he's always there. Just call on him. And he brings that his power, and he involves you, and he raises you up out of that deep hole that you feel like you're in. And you feel glory. You know, you're surrounded by angels and love and encouragement. And during that time, my daughter was here, and she was trying to get through the situation alone. We didn't have a vehicle, just wouldn't run. And then all of a sudden, one day, God touched it, and it started running. The funniest thing, and you've heard the story before, we were going to sell the car to keep those, and but someone told me, you know, it had a growing engine and all that. It's a long story, but anyway, we got it one day. We were cleaning it up and checking all the fluids and charging the battery, getting ready to sell. And we got the car and we were starting it. And all of a sudden the radio came on, which the radio was not working. And we were pushing buttons and all this type of thing. And we pushed this one button. And it was from God. And the only thing it said on the radio came across the radio was, "Praise the Lord." Out of all the words in the world, all the messy bits in the world, anything, you know, you can't even imagine what we felt. We looked at each other, bewildered, and said, "What thing?" Praise the Lord. And we feel the other thing. And the car's running, it's not heating up. And I just thank God for so many things. My brother is settled in. It's been a year. He's doing fine. You know, never give up.
Never.
We have our weak moments, and we want to say, "Oh, is it worth it?" But you know, something is worth it. Because our reward is heaven, eternal life. This life doesn't mean anything. We put so much importance on it at the moment. But you know, we have eternal life to look forward to. And if we just stay focused on that, you know, it'll be worth it all. It really will. We'll get through this life no matter what. And so I praise the Lord for all the blessings and the challenges, good or bad, doesn't matter. You know, we're strong. And we have to stay strong in Him.
That's a good faith message.
Never lose your faith. Never lose your faith.
You know, I believe it was Gabriel, the angel, that I talked to Mary. Said, "All things are possible. All things." What is all things?
I was up like late last night praying because there was some things going on in my family and in the church family. And I always hear things from the Lord about the new year and what's happened. And the Lord reminded me that last year we have come through some horrendous situations. They're not all been health trials. Some of them have just been so much piled on at one time and just so many things. But and even as the new year was being brought in, we were hearing things. But this is a different year. The power of God is what is going to break the yoke. And the Lord Himself is going to show Himself faithful to His church because He is faithful, and He said He would. He said before He comes back, we're going to be doing mighty signs and wonders and greater than He did. Now, I have seen some signs and wonders in my life, how men think of strength, lifting up weights and stuff like that, but it's not. It's those that are on their knees knowing that he is. If it weren't for the Lord, where would any of us be? He chooses the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. So do you think the foolish things of this world are going to do it? No. It's going to be God in us, the hope of glory.
Yes.
And it's going to happen. It's going to begin to start happening in this year. And it's only going to escalate. But the church is going to be the church victorious.
This is it.
And I was really excited when I heard some of that. It's like, okay. And the Lord said, as you realize that there is no good thing in you as of yourself before you were saved, now all power,
yes,
all power is given unto us. We just need to believe it and act on it. And I'm including myself there because a lot of times I think because I've seen some things, like the Lord told me one day when I was widowed and I was alone, and it was a bad windstorm, and the trailer was going, and I woke up in the middle of the night, and I hate big winds, and I was like, oh no. And that scripture started going through my head. There shall, Psalm 92. Psalm 91. Yeah, there, and 1,000 at your left, and so many thousand at your right, but it shall not befall you. And I said, and here's me. But Lord, I know people that have been in tornadoes and things, and they were Christian. And the Lord said, I told you. And it was so strong that I laid my head back down on the pillow and I said, yes, sir, and I went right back to sleep. But that's how it's going to have to be. We're going to have to become his children again and say, you know what? Maybe there is no Santa Claus, but what I got is a lot, lot better.
Yes. Glory. I stayed in my war room almost 4 hours yesterday. And I just stayed till I heard from the Lord. And 2017 is going to be a great year for the church. We are the church, the body of Christ. It's going to be things to take place that we never dreamed of. I'm telling you. I can tell you, I had one to have yesterday, but I ain't going to tell you. And, I mean, God, just awesome, boy. I'm telling you. I mean, he just showed himself strong to me.
God is so good.
And he will you.
How do you feel this year has been one of the hardest years that you've gone through? I know I have. In my spirit, I feel that the Lord says, Satan can't this year. Now it's my turn.
Yes.
Now it's my turn.
I believe church, look, we have planted some good seed in 2016.
Yes.
And we're going to get the harvest in 2017. Anybody else?
Pastor, excuse me just a minute, but this is so true what Sister Linda said and everything. It said, the Lord gave me this psalm probably about a month ago, and I was praying over our grandson and praying over different situations. And the Lord just brought me to this, and I read it over and over and over. Listen to it. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say. And so I put my name in there where Israel was. And if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us. Now, we don't consider people, but we do know principalities and powers and circumstances come against us. Then they swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us. The streams had gone over our soul, where it was saying, you know, we would have been completely destroyed with the circumstances of life. But said, bless me the Lord who hath not given us as a prey to our enemy. So he hasn't done that. He's caused us to triumph, so we know the Lord's on our side, another scripture says. It said, our soul, this is the scripture of the Lord, our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken. And when I read that word, something hit my spirit. And I believe you can look at the enemy and say, the snare is gone. I am totally and completely delivered from the hand of the enemy. The snare is broken and we are escaped. We're free. And as Sister Linda said, the more we just learn to say yes sir to him, the quicker it's going to be in our lives. And says, our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. And so God's on our side. Who feeds for us, who can be against us? And we just need to remind the enemy that we know who's on our side. Amen. Praise God. Brother Will, I'm sorry.
And sit by her, and so, you know, I've just been
I've been meditating on Pastor Dorothy's message all week. And everything had come to me that I didn't like. I said, Lord, you done been through that. You overcome it for me, so I'm overcoming it.
Yes.
No matter what comes your way, God has already overcome it.
Yes.
And he didn't overcome it for himself. He overcome it for me and you. And so, whatever comes, headache, sickness, or whatever it is, say, Lord, you don't overcome that for me.
Right.
So I'm overcoming it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I've just done a little research myself. I really got a blessing out of that message last week. Nothing that comes your way bad that God hadn't already overcome it. Jesus had overcome it. He was tempted in all matters, just like you are. And like I was. Everything you've been tempted with, he's been tempted with. And the reason why he was tempted, yet without sin, he overcome it, or I can overcome it. I don't know how you would do it. He overcome it for me. Sickness, sickness. Jesus overcome you, so I'm overcoming you too. No matter what comes your way, Jesus has already overcome it for one reason, where you can overcome it. We don't have no excuse. No excuse. He's already overcome it. In Hebrews 2, chapter 2, verse 18, it says, for in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to help them that are tempted. Able to help any time you're tempted with sickness or whatever comes your way. He has already overcome it and wants to help you overcome it. Help me overcome. In Hebrews 4:15, it says, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was at all points tempted like as we are. Say, like as we are.
Like we are.
Yet without sin. So, church, we can live without sin. We can live without sin because God has given us the power to overcome it. In James 1:2, I've lived this verse for many, many years. It said, my brother, count it all joy when you fall into battle of temptation. He goes on to say, knowing this, let patience have its perfect work. You come out with nothing. I remember one time, years ago, I was living in Springfield. Lord had bought him a van. He probably done forgot. But he was at school. The starter went out on it, and he couldn't get the starter on, so I was going to put it on for him. But the thing up in the top of it, where you put the top screw, they didn't have all these bottom tubes that you got today. And I stayed on that thing for, I know, 4 hours, and trying to get that one screw in there. And so, the scripture came to me and I just started saying, Lord, I count it all joy. I count it all joy. You know what? Man, that screw will hit just like that. I mean, and you know, I've noticed in my life, I was putting a fan up in Pastor Dorothy's house. And I couldn't get the screws in it. Any of you put up a fan? And just about the time I get it in it, I start shaking it. Jump out. And so I started saying, I counted all joy. You know what? It wasn't but a few seconds I had all them screws in there. A lot of times we go through stuff a long time because we don't call on God to help.
Sure.
But that scripture has helped me more than counted all joy. You mean counted joy when things come at you back? Yeah, because God will deliver you. He's going to deliver you. James chapter 1 verse 12 says, blessed is the man that endures temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to them that love him. How many of you love him?
Amen.
No, both hands up. I love him. But he's promised a crown. I love a crown. JoJo, she likes a crown to get it. I don't know where we go. Is it not McDonald's.
Burger King.
He put a crown. She'll wear that crown. You know, hey, you're going to have a crown one day. We might want to start going to Burger King and practice. Hallelujah. Get ready to wear a crown. Amen. And verse 13, let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempt he any man. So God never tempts us. Never tempts us. It's always the devil, or we tempted ourselves with our flesh. 2 Peter 2:9 says, the Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptation, and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. So we don't have to worry about unjust people. God's going to take care of them at the right time. Amen. And we're just a little side note. I studied on that. I got a blessing out of it. Everything that come my way, Jesus has already conquered it for me, and for you. And so we need to realize that no matter what comes your way, you can have what? Victory. So we need to let the world know we got victory. That we ain't just barely getting along, that we're living on high ground, that we're blessed. You know, I may not have $10 in my pocket, but I'm blessed. I'm blessed to be here today. I'm blessed to be able to lift both hands and praise God. I may be battling in my body or something, but I'm blessed because he's my healer. I'm going to praise him. Well, we walk by faith and not by sight. And there's a lot of people here today who walk by faith. And God here, God's going to take care of them. Faith works. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, the Bible says, now faith is. So when did I get healed?
Now.
When did I get blessed?
Now.
When I go to my post office box, what am I supposed to say? There's money in the box. So faith is now. There's blessings in the box. I was out the post office, there wasn't nothing in it. And I said, I'm blessed. And this person said, what do you mean you're blessed? I said, ain't no bills in there. So you're blessed if you don't get a bill, right?
Right.
Amen. So use your faith. Let your faith work for you. How many of you know your faith will work for you? Put it to work. God give you the measure of faith to take care of yourself with. And put your faith to work. Hallelujah. For God hadn't given us, as Sister Linda was talking, God hadn't given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. How many of you looked in the mirror this morning and said, I've got love, power, and a sound mind? I knew him once and said, Lord, I've got love, power, and a sound mind. I'll never have Alzheimer's. Make it confession. Confession brings possession. And in Proverbs 13:15, it says, a good understanding giveth favor. But the last part of that verse is out. That the way of the transgressor is hard. There's a lot of people out there having a hard way, you know, and they don't realize why it is. They're transgressing. Say it with me. The way of the transgressor is hard. People that don't be a doer of God's word is transgressing. James, put it this way, James 1:20. Be a doer of the word, not a hearer only. Deceiving, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of people in my family that's deceiving their own self. And then I tell you, they ain't having too easy a time getting back. Say it with me. The way of the transgressor is hard. But what is a transgressor? That's somebody that don't acknowledge the word of God. You don't hear what the word says. Amen. A good understanding give us favor. You know, I always tell them, have a good understanding with people and you won't have a misunderstanding. I learned a lot from a gentleman we bought our farm from, and he wasn't even a Christian. He said, when I die, I just want to prepare me on the hill in the evening time. Don't want nobody there. He died. I don't know what he lived up to tonight, but I used to witness to him. He said, if somebody gets you once, woe unto them. But if they get you twice, woe unto you. I got to remind myself of this, I'm telling you. Because sometimes a man comes to the house here a while back, knocked on the door, and he said, Pastor, if you'll let me have $20, I'll be back Wednesday and pay you. I said, now, are you telling me the truth? Yes, sir, I'm telling you the truth. Wednesday showed up, and I looked for him, and he never did show up. Well, he'd come back on Friday. He said, Pastor, I know I owe you $20, but if you'll let me have 10 more, I'll get my money Thursday, and I'll be back and pay you the whole 30. I said, are you telling me the truth? He said, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. So I have to have 10. But Thursday ain't never come. So I got to learn a good lesson. I've learned a good lesson. I just got to obey it. If a man gets you once, go unto him. If he gets you twice, go unto you. So the second time he got me, was go unto me. And so, you know, how in the world did that man, I'm looking at him right dead in the eye. How in the world could he look me dead in the eye and just plain lie to me? If I tell you something, I'm going to do the best to do it, right? A good understanding gives you favor. As I said, all of us together as a church, we planted and modeled. And then individually, When you smile at somebody, or when you do somebody a good deed or something, you're planting. And planting good ground. And Paul said, I planted, Paulus watered, but who gives the increase?
God.
How many of you look for the increase?
Amen.
Church, let me encourage you. Just look for the increase every day. God wants to bless you. He wants to bless you. Don't put him in a box. Don't put him in a box. And don't turn down a blessing. I heard Brother Kenneth Hagin say one time that this individual walked up and they gave him $2. And he said, I thought, I could really do without that. And I know he needs it worse than I do. But if I don't receive it, I'm going to knock him out with blessings.
Sure.
Blessing. Because see, as you give, you get blessed. Right?
Amen.
Get out of my throat, you devil. In Jesus' name. In Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 1. I love that verse. I was Pastor Dalton was somewhere the other day, and I'm listening to my Bible. And I got over to it. It says, cast thy bread upon the waters, for thou shalt find it after many days.
Robert.
How many of you got some waves coming in? That's what I like to think. I got some waves coming in, because I've been casting my bread on the water. And I know I got some waves coming in. And Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 6 is an awesome scripture. It said, in the morning, everybody say in the morning.
In the morning.
Sow thy seed. When do we sow?
In the morning.
You know, and that don't make no difference what morning it is. I mean, that's just like sowing a smile or being kind to somebody or giving somebody a jar of jelly. Sister Elsie, boy, she really blessed me. I mean, she gave me jelly and cookies if she'd get by Brother Ryan. she makes good cookies, don't you, Brother?
She does.
Good cookies. in the morning sow thy seed, and in the evening withhold not thy hand, for thou knowest not whether shall prosper either this or that, or whether they both shall be alike good. I love that, church. If I sow seed in the morning, then something good is going to come to me before the day is over. Before the day is over. And I expect it. And it's not a sin to expect it. We got to expect it. Look what Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6 said. Everybody knows it. But without faith, it's impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. We have to diligently seek him. Just like Exodus 23, verse 25 and 26 said, serve the Lord. He'll bless you bread and your water, and he'll take sickness out of the midst of you. What's the key word there? Serve. Serve. So I asked myself, Lord, am I serving you? And he said, the number of your days I will fulfill. Church, that's the awesome promise. I'm telling you. My buddy, me and Brother Ronnie work with Pharaoh. Called me this morning. He's 89 years old. He said, Pastor Benny, I got a new CD. I'm coming to your church to sing it. I said, come ahead. He said, I'll let you know when I'm coming. You know, he's the one that come. He got a new CD, 89. Still out going for the Lord. Why, you think I'm going to tell him not to come? No, Lord, no. Push him on. I hope he can come when he's 100. Look, Joe, we don't need to never hold nobody back. Put some fire on them. Throw some gas on them and light them. 89. I got a blessing out of them. We worked with him. I worked with him for over 31 years. Him and his brother. One time the IRS checked them. They said there's no way anybody can give that much money to the Lord and still live. See, they didn't know the key. As you give, it'll be give back, pressed down, shaken together. Running over will mend giving. A lot of people are hurting today because they think they can't give. Well, if you don't give, it'll never come back to you. You have to give. Start out little, I mean. Start out giving, and watch God bless you. He'll bless you. Must believe that he is a rewarder of them. The dark world needs to know that. God wants to reward us. He wants us to reward. I'm glad to send this young man back to church. Listen, God wants to reward you. He wants to bless you. What do you work? Are you out of school?
I gotta catch up with some credit.
Right. Work hard and you'll never be broke. Get a good education, work hard, and you'll never be broke. That's the message for our young people. Get a good education, work hard, and you'll never be broke. Hallelujah. When I was born, my daddy spanked me and said, get it. And I've been getting it ever since. I'll be 80 on my birthday. I ain't forgot it. And Luke 6:38, it says give. Everybody say give. What's the key to this verse? Give, just like serve is the key to Exodus 23, 25, 26. If I serve the Lord, when you go to a restaurant and these waiters serve you. So how do you serve the Lord? You serve the Lord by being a doer of the word.
Amen.
Find what the word said. Many people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because they don't know what the word said. Give, and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men give into your bosom, for with the same measure that you meant with, whether it shall be measured unto you. Give, and it shall. Did you know the word shall is the strongest word in the dictionary? Shall be given back to you. Hallelujah. You may get a raise at your work. You may go to the post office box and get a check. RIS may send you more money than you think you got to have. Any of you ever been there? I ain't never been there with a heart yet, but I still believe that he'd do it.
That's right.
Amen. Blessings can come to you in so many different ways. You help.
Amen.
What a blessing health is. What a blessing that I was able to get up and sit on the side of the bed this morning and feel good. I had to wait till I got in gear, but I felt good. That's a blessing, church. It's a blessing to feel. It's a blessing to have a good appetite.
Yes,
there's a man at work asked me one time, said, sit down and write 100 things and God will bless you with. I thought, man, 100 things? But you know what? You'd write 1,000 things.
Oh, yeah.
Bless you. He blessed us with a good country. A good country. We're free to come to church. I know they try to take it away, but they can't. God is bigger than they are. He's bigger than they are. And we just say Merry Christmas now. I'm thinking they're going to carry us to jail. There's going to be many more things we can do that they said we couldn't do, but that we're doing anyway. Amen. I had a mess officer one time, Frank Traughber. He said, just because they said you can't do it, don't mean you can't. Well, they say, us Christians can't do what we can. Amen. Sowing and reaping. Say, sowing and reaping.
Amen.
This works in every way of my life. Sorry. In Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, 8, and 9. The Bible says, be not deceived. Everybody say that. Be not deceived. God is not mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Church, watch what kind of seeds you sow. Because the crop that you sow is going to be the crop that you reap. Amen. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. How many of you know that works in your life? I tell you, if you don't believe there's a God, you watch what you sow and you watch you reap. Amen. I know the first 33 years of my life, I sowed bad seed. And I tell you, I didn't get by with none of them. And the ones that I thought I hadn't reaped, I repented. I said, God, forgive me. Forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. Lord, put it in the seal, forgive me. Never remember no more. He'll do it. You don't have to worry about your past. It's your future. Satan don't care nothing about your past. It's your future he's trying to knock you out. Amen? Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Say, I sow good seed.
I sow good
seed. I sow good seed. It brings health to my body. It brings finances to me. It helped me get bless my family, bless my church, and that's what I live for. We live to take care of our family, to bless our church, to bless the work of the Lord. If you do that, well, I'll tell you what, God will take care of you. Yes. Everybody stand this minute and stretch. I ain't got about an hour and a half.
All right.
Got some good stuff here. I'm telling you. I got it out of my war room. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth. Think about what you sow. When the devil comes to you and tries to get you to do something wrong, think about it. Because whatever you do, you're going to reap it. Amen. The Bible says, be careful. Your sins will find you out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can sit down when you want to, not because I'm telling you to. I can teach while you stand. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 8, for he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. In my family, there have been two to die with cirrhosis. sold to the flesh. I sold to the flesh. Many people blame God and other things, but if you sold to the flesh, you're going to reap corruption for your flesh. I mean, that's not me saying that, that's the Lord. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap everlasting life.
Amen.
Macon County has got more cancer patients than any other county. Well, if you go anywhere and you open your eyes, just about everybody you run into has got one of them sticks in their mouth. And what does the fact say? It causes cancer. So if you sow to the flesh, you're going to what? Reap to the flesh. And boy, I know I'm telling you the truth. My flesh used to crave that nicotine. God delivered me instantly with alcohol and stuff like that. Nicotine, man. Because I went to a church that thought it was all right to use it. I mean, after Sunday school, they'd all have a circle outside and smoke a cigarette. So naturally, I just come in, I'm just a young Christian. But it ain't. I mean, you don't put nothing in your body to harm it, right? Verse 9. Let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint. Now, I'm not going to faint. And I know you're not. No matter what my body's telling me, if it's telling me I'm not going to get well or whatever it is, I'm not going to faint. I'm going to believe I am and I'll get well. It's according to your faith, but being unbelieved. We shall reap. Galatians 6:10. As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men. Everybody say especially. Unto them who are of the household of faith. Do good. What did Jesus do? Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Say, doing good. Get up and one say, I'm going to do good. I'm going to do good. I'm going to do good. I'm going to, praise God, where time goes. I'm going to do good. Got to hurry up. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing what? Good, healing all that was oppressed of the devil. Be not deceived. Come on, more scripture. Be not deceived. Just listen to this word. And as he entered into a certain village in Luke chapter 17, verse 12, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. They couldn't get around the crowd. And they had to stand way off, about where Brother Leslie is back there. And they had to holler, I'm a leper, I'm a leper, I'm a leper.
Unclean.
Because you couldn't get around. Verse 3, and they lift up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. They approached him the right way. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And you know, that's the same thing that happens to people that come to church and come up for prayer and all. If they believe it, as they go, they may get healed as they go, or they may get healed there. But you got to believe it. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. As they went, they were cleansed. Think about that. It didn't say they were made whole. there's a key to being cleansed and a key to being made whole, I believe. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice, glory to God. Say this with me. With a loud voice. He glorified God. They didn't just say, thank you, Lord. No! They hollered, I'm healed! Hallelujah! Glory, glory, glory. With a loud voice. The church had lost their loud voice. You know why? They scared somebody to think funny. I don't care what people think. I'm healed. Hallelujah! Glory to God. If I'm just healed, when I shout, I'm going to be made whole. Woo! Glory! Look what happened. As they went, they were healed. Let me find my place. With a loud voice, glorified God, and fell down on his face at the feet, at his feet, giving him thanks that he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answered and said, were there not 10 cleansed? Were the 9? Well, we've seen a multitude of people healed here. I don't know where they're at. But we've seen a multitude healed. But thank God for you and me that we've come back to give him thanks and praise him. Amen. And Jesus answered and said, were there not 10 cleansed? But were there 9 that are not found that return to give glory to God, save the stranger? So that's what we're doing today. That's what the testimony is. We're giving glory to God. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith has made thee whole. I don't know about you, but I want to be whole. Don't we, sister love? We want to be whole, whole, whole. Why? We got work to do. We got work to do. We got things to do for Jesus. With a loud voice.